Dear friends, it's a. I've always been. आ जाएंगे. हो जाएंगे, हो जाएंगे. अभी आपके लिए बहुत नाराबाजी सदन के अंदर किया था इसलिए गला थोड़ा खराब. तो ये संघर्ष सदन के अंदर और बाहर हम करेंगे. उसमें कोई डाउट नहीं है उसके बारे में. I've always been here as a student activist, and as a student leader to this university for the past 15 years. And what I have understood as a being a student leader is JNU doesn't have a language, JNU doesn't have a religion, JNU doesn't have a region. And that is the beauty of JNU, which the government is trying to do. Fees hike hai. ये जो फीस हाइक है एक ट्रैप है. आप उस पर फंस गया तो आज इंदिरा जी के जन्मदिन है. जो इस विश्वविद्यालय को, महत्वपूर्ण विश्वविद्यालय को आगे बढ़ाने के लिए काफी कोशिश किया है. और जवाहरलाल नेहरू जो नाम है, ये नाम सुनकर ही बहुत पैरानोइड हो जाता है ये सरकार के लोग और मोदी सरकार और जितना भी विरोध उनसे है उस नाम से है. इस विश्वविद्यालय ने क्या किया भैया? ये विश्वविद्यालय हर समय जितने भी लोगों को प्रोड्यूस किया है, एकेडमिक्स में जो कंट्रीब्यूशंस किया है, सेंटर ऑफ एकेडमिक एक्सेलेंस है. विदाउट एनी रीजन द गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू डिस्ट्रॉय दिस यूनिवर्सिटी. द फीस हाइक इज टोटली अनएक्सेप्टेबल. द पीसफुल मार्च which was brutally attacked by the central forces and the police forces, especially against the girls, is totally and strongly, I strongly condemn on the act of the police. My colleagues have already raised this issue in the parliament, but aajkal kyun hai na, parliament mein, abhi jo sir ne bola, aapka jo march parliament se ja raha tha, parliament ke aur ja raha tha, usko rok diya tha. And what would have been if you go to the parliament? If you go to the parliament, nowadays what they do is, in a few days' time, they are going to sell one of the biggest public sector undertaking called the Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited. So it's already signed with Reliance and Ambani. So it's an 8.5 lakh crore worth assets, which has a huge distribution across the country. Bharat Petroleum Corporation Limited, BSNL, Air India, and all the public sector undertakings are being sold. So, if the sir want to go to the parliament, sir, ye bhi bikne wala hai. Unka koshish hoga ki ye kitna paisa, Sidharaman ji, aapka product hai na? And she knows the exact value. She knows the exact value of the university. Kitna acre zameen hai? कितना इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है यहाँ पे, तो उसके ऊपर वो कॉन्ट्रैक्ट मार देंगे. तो अभी मेरा प्रदेश से कोचिन में एक वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट रिफाइनरीज भारत पेट्रोलियम कॉर्पोरेशन हैज द कोचिन रिफाइनरीज. वी रिक्वेस्टेड द प्राइम मिनिस्टर टू कम टू द पीपल ऑफ द रिफाइनरी, रिक्वेस्टेड मोदी टू कम टू द refinery, and at the end, just before the election, he came. And it is when he understood, because he travels across the globe, but he finds very less time in India. And he came to Kerala, South India, southern part of India, he came and he visited. And he was shocked to see that, oh, this is an institution which is in Kerala. Unfortunately, BJP doesn't have so much of stake there. So he couldn't visit there, and he understood the value and potential of the Cochin refinery, and he decided to make sure that that is no more. So please don't come to the parliament. Your university also will be sold. So our efforts, the members of the parliament, I should say that many of the like-minded members of the parliament from many different parties are supporting JNU. We will continue our support. And tell you one thing very clearly, the government historically, wherever we have seen in many different countries, wherever we have autocratic rule, in those countries Students have led the agitations, students have led the movement, and we are also going to win a movement led by the students, and this is the end of a government. Beginning of the fall of a government, and we extend our full-hearted support to withdraw the fee hike, to withdraw the cases. The peaceful march was very brutally attacked by the police and the central forces, which cannot be accepted, and it had to be withdrawn. Avas do!